Hello everyone. AWS Web Application Firewall, WAF, is a service that helps you protect your web applications against common web exploits and bots that can affect availability, compromise security, or consume excessive resources. AWS WAF lets you control access to your content based in conditions that you specify, such as the source IP address of requests, the values of query strings, or the geographic location of the source request. AWS WAF geographic match statements can add labels to each request to indicate the country and region code that the request originates from. This enables requests to be processed according to the regions that you wish to allow or block. Building on the geographic match ability within AWS WAF, we recently released a new feature that you can use to build precise geographic rules based on ISO 3166 country and area codes. With this release, you can now manage access at a more granular level to allow the creation of more specific and precise firewall rules. These rules can also be combined with other AWS WAF rules to build more comprehensive filtering policies. For example, if you wish to block certain geographies while still allowing certain developer IP addresses from those locations, you can combine geographic and IP match conditions to allow only authorized users. The release of these features mean that AWS WAF users can now filter requests by much more specific geographic information and scope rules to specific USA states, for example. Let's now navigate to the AWS WAF console to see these features in action. So I'm going to navigate now to the AWS WAF and Shield console, and this is where we can configure the new feature and try it out. We're going to start by going to our web ACLs. Now, if you don't have a web ACL created in the region that you're using, you're going to have to create one of those first. I do have a test one here that I created earlier. And the web ACL is essentially a container for your rule groups and rules that we're going to be using in this demo. If we go into the settings for the web ACL and navigate to rules, add rules, you can see that we can add manage rules, coming from an AWS managed rule group or a third-party managed rule group, or we can add our own rules. For this example, we're going to add our own rules. You have a choice here as well to do it via the sort of console itself, or you can use the rule editor and do it in JSON format. For this demo, we'll just use the console itself. And I'm just going to call this geomatch. We can set this as a regular rule or a rate-based rule, the difference being that the rate-based rule will only kick into action after a certain number of requests, after a threshold has been met. And then as we scroll down, we have the choice to configure the logic of the rule itself. So we're going to set it to match all the statements. We're going to use AND logic here. And we're going to start by originates from a country. Now for this example, you can see that we can choose pretty much all of the countries available, but for this example I'm going to use the United States because it works quite well as an example to look at the states themselves within the United States of America. So we're going to say that the traffic originates from a country in the United States, and then for our second part of logic, we're going to say has a label. And here you can configure any label you like, and there is documentation in the developer guide that has a list of these labels for specific region codes. I am going to use this one, which is AWS WAF Client IP Geo Region US Texas. So what we're seeing here is the traffic originates from within the United States of America, but also, because we're using the AND logic, AND, it must have the label specific to the state of Texas, and the firewall assigns this label to traffic passing through it from that state. And previously to the release of this feature, we could do things at country level, like United States, which was pretty useful, but it didn't allow the flexibility of really narrowing things down to specific states, cities or regions within the world. And that's what we're sort of showing here, a demonstration of being able to do this in a much more granular and precise level. We then have the option of what do we want to do if this rule's true. So we can allow the traffic, we can block it, we can present some kind of challenge or capture
for users to solve if they meet that criteria, or we can use count. Count's pretty useful whenever you're creating a new rule because it allows you to see how many things are going to match that rule without actually taking any action on them. So by setting it to count, we're just observing for the time being. And then we can later go in and change that to, you know, allow or block or challenge once we've got an idea of what the impact will be. So I'm going to hit add rule, and we can see the criteria here for the priority. In this demonstration, I'm only using this one rule, but if you have multiple rules here, you can adjust the priority so that they're processed in the order that you desire. So that's it for this video on AWS WAF Granular Geographic Matching. But if you'd like to know more about this feature, have a look at the documentation or the WAF Developer Guide.